Shortcuts can be extremely useful in Inkscape, and in this video, I'll show 12 best shortcuts to save time and effort while working with sewing patterns. I'm starting by importing a stitched PDF. A link to PDF Stitcher software website is in the description. It's a free Key West tank by Pattern Niche. It imports grouped and we'll need to ungroup it later, but first let me show you this trick. Click any line with Control, and you can select the object inside of the group directly. I often use it to remove page numbers using Edit Select Same Fill and Stroke. You can create a shortcut for this one too, and I even have done so, but for some reason failed to memorize it. From here we also could duplicate the object with Ctrl D to leave the original intact. As we can see in the Objects panel, if you don't see the Objects panel, it's under Object Objects, the new copy is right next to the original in the same group. This can create undesirable side effects like when you pull it to the side, and it just disappears, or you try to color it, and see no reaction. First select all with Ctrl A. To get rid of the group structure, or ungroup, we use Shift Ctrl G. Each press removes one level of groups. Ungrouping is a slow process. There is a slightly faster extension named Deep Ungroup, but it's buggy. It's a good idea to save the document as SVG, the native format of Inkscape, at the start of your work, and use Ctrl S to save the progress. If your pattern just turned into a bunch of lines like mine, you've pressed Shift G accidentally. This is the shortcut for Object, Objects to Guides, and it's not a part of this video. Ctrl Z will fix the problem. For some reason in Inkscape you usually have to press Ctrl Z twice. I recommend to keep going until the status bar in the bottom shows there are no groups. Our copy becomes visible even before that. The status bar contains wealth of knowledge and often tells you what's wrong and how to fix this. Inkscape is usually good at making auto-saved copies, but better safe than sorry. Since we have this pattern piece on fold, let's unfold it. Duplicate to get the other side and flip it horizontally with easy shortcut H or V if you need it flipped vertically. Pull it to the original piece until it snaps. Snapping often needs to be turned on and off, and there is a shortcut, %, for just that. I'll union two pieces to make them one, and let's say we need to add more seam allowance. Maybe we plan flat felled seams. Usually I do this with a copy. Ctrl D again, give it a different color, and put it under the original shape. Pressing End will sync the object to the bottom, and Page Down will only lower it one level. I use Outset for adding seam allowance, the shortcut is Ctrl Closing Bracket. There is also Inset with Ctrl Opening Bracket. I'll group the original and the one with seam allowance together for convenience with Ctrl G. Now we can pull them around as one. We can also rotate them as one if we click the second time. Handles in the corners rotate the object around this plus sign in the center. It's pretty small and pale if you aren't using new version 1.1 yet, it's just released recently. Moving the rotation center lets us pivot the pieces, a useful technique for pattern adjustments. When you encounter a pattern piece that is made of several paths, selecting both paths' end nodes and pressing Shift J will join them into one node, effectively fusing two paths together. If you need to trace a shape with Bezier curves, it's handy to create corners as you go. Shift L was a well-kept secret until recently, now it can be found in the keys and mouse reference. This is just one of the manual tracing methods, it's very fast, but has a steep learning curve, pun intended. Sometimes you have a node without handles, but you can easily pull the handles out while holding Shift. I know I said 12 shortcuts, but who doesn't love a little bonus? A shortcut for moving the selected objects to layer above is a handy one if you need to separate the lines to the different layers. It's Shift Page Up, and there is a Shift Page Down too. First you'd need to add a new layer, name it, and then select the object to be moved. If you like what you are seeing on my channel, consider subscribing, and please suggest the topics for the future videos in the comments. An alternative to complete ungrouping is Object, pop the object out of the group. It moves the object one level up in the objects tree. Usually just a few times are enough, and it's faster than ungrouping all of it. No shortcuts in the reference, but it can be assigned in the preferences. It's Edit, Preferences, Interface, Keyboard, or Keyboard Shortcuts if you aren't using Inkscape 1.1 yet, have I told you already it's just released. In their search for pop to assign a shortcut. I've set it to Shift Alt G to keep the similarity to grouping and ungrouping. Now you can see the object climbing the tree each time I press the newly assigned shortcut. A handy method of adding flair to the hems or sleeves is called scale nodes in Inkscape. I'll show it on the full front pattern piece. Select all nodes of the hem with a node tool. Hold a dot on the keyboard to add flair or a comma to reduce it. There is also a button on the panel to show transformation handles and scale selected nodes as if they were an object. With them visible, hold Shift and pull the sideways handle to modify the hem. Watch these videos about seam allowance, joining nodes, and mirroring the pattern pieces if you haven't yet. See you soon.